distant lovers, but we off in the same bed. You said I never think about you like I'm brain dead. High in this Cooper pound of runs in the 8 of red. Playing with your pussy, wishing that it was me instead. I wanna give, but trying to maintain a level head. I live with no regrets.
Love and loyalty, your boy Juice Hefner.
Clutch.
China.
And this is the lovely, we got a special guest, my bad, the lovely Jasmine.
Hey. Shout out to Jasmine because she's a Gemini. So you got 2, 4, 6 people today. Six of us.
It ain't the brave, huh? Well, yeah, I'm in this, so, right?
Yeah.
Hey, look, so first question we ask everyone, you have to choose between love and loyalty. What would you pick and why?
You can't pick. I can't pick. Not picking love. No, I can't pick.
Why do you feel like you can't pick?
Cause you can't pick loyalty because people are just loyal to you for a time period.
Ooh, so that's an expiration date.
Always. To me. And I feel the same about love. You can love you one day.
So it's all for a reason, basically.
Mm-hmm.
Time. You're going for whatever specific reason.
Mm-hmm.
Or you love me for this reason. Okay.
Mm-hmm. I thought she was going to say something else. I'm right here thinking like, what the fuck do you mean you can't pick? Basic love or loyalty, like shit. He don't want people to know you want real loyalty, you want real fucking love.
What answer did you think she was gonna give?
Loyalty.
Why you said that?
Shit's good, like shit. In general, like even though I had you answer the expiration date, I don't think real loyalty is an expiration date for that. I really don't. I don't think real love, I really don't think it's an expiration date for that. Real love.
Yeah, what's real love?
Fine. Okay, like I say this, the way I feel for my kids, the way my kids love me, like to the point, like I said, when you had your baby, she was born, you instantly loved her, right? Not knowing nothing, just you loved her,
do
right?
Do you think you love anybody else like that?
Like my kid?
Mm-hmm.
No, not like that.
You can love a person like you love your kids. You can.
How old your kids?
15 and 10.
See, our kids then are grown. So they pushing you out. They ready to leave. They about to leave.
They trying to push you out the house.
They about to leave.
Yeah. But
they young, like, nah, like, and I got 2 boys. My dogs, like, shit. I love them out there. I'm saying my niggas. I love my boy. But like, shit, I don't know. Hey, look, I want to talk to y'all about forgetting and forgiving. So with this, this can go to a bunch of different things, relationships, life in general, everything. So I thought about this because it's crazy. Like I said, my brother dad and shit.
Right.
My brother dad, when we went to the little court shit, my old dude was praying. I remember he said some shit like, I forgive dude that killed my brother. Mm. I'm like, nigga, what the fuck you mean you forgive him? But that's how I'm thinking. I'm like, you forgive him? He's like, yeah, I'm looking like that's some bullshit. I seen an old head say the other day, he's like, man, it's impossible. Because I was like, I wonder, can I ever forgive a nigga? They're like, it's impossible to forgive somebody if you don't forget it. It's like, they like, we can't do that. And I talked to like my cousin, I talked to different people, they're like, that's not true.
To forgive and or forget?
Like, you gotta do both of them. Like, okay, let me use in a relationship. Guy in a relationship, he cheat on you. You take him back, so you quote unquote forgave him, right?
Mm-hmm.
But you would never, ever fully forgive him, let you forget it. Because they say it's to the point you bring it back up when you're mad.
I ain't forgetting that shit.
Yeah,
you're not going to forgive him?
I don't know. Now you cheating on me, I ain't going to forgive it. But I ain't forgiving me. But I mean, that's a different story, but no.
What you mean you ain't forgiving me?
No, you ain't cheating on me. What the fuck you cheating for?
So what that mean? So you said one strike, you're out.
What is you cheating for?
I'm asking you.
No, yeah, one strike, you fucking out. What you cheating for?
Because of you.
Oh, well, then we don't need to be here.
That's what I'm saying.
Then it's no, you don't need to cheat. We just need to stop fucking with each other.
Yeah, I'm saying you advertising something that you ain't give me.
No, you ain't fall for that.
Yes, I did.
So then you break up, right?
You told me out of 7 days a week, we going to fuck 5 of them days. That's what you told me. Now we've been fucking 2 days after the damn week. I'm upset about it. When I want the pussy, you ain't giving it to me.
Well, you need to break up. If you're not happy with it, we need to break. If we can't work on it together.
I'm saying we can't.
You just gonna go straight to Gino.
I went outside, I just happened to have a moment. It happened.
No, you ain't having no motherfucking moment. We gonna do this shit. We gonna get it together 7 days a week.
Look, that's okay. What do you say? Because you already told me.
Never forget. You can forgive at some point. Cheating, I forgive you, or when I forgive you.
So you can, okay, so you can take a nigga back.
If I forgive you.
You can take a nigga back. You can be in a relationship with this dude. Mm-hmm. You saying in general, like, 3 years down the line, mm-hmm. you still fully ain't forgiven. You know, that's crazy.
Yeah, no. I will probably forgive you, and then if anything happened, I'm going to remember it again. But you're not going to forget it, because you're going to always remember something.
So like I said, with that mindset right there, saying you basically would never ever forgive them, like truly, unless you forget everything.
I forgive you enough by accepting that.
I guess you still forgive them, you ain't forget it. Like,
yeah. You can't forgive
for them. Instance, all right, so I had a partner. He used to do scandalous shit to people, but I don't know to other people, but he'd make it back right. You know what I'm saying?
Make what back right?
Whatever he did. All right, so for instance.
He's
not
right.
So look, I was working at Walmart mm-hmm. out in Chesterfield for probably like a month or something. He stayed out that way, so his mom was gonna pick him up from the Walmart. So I gave him keys, like, let me run to McDonald's real quick. I let the nigga run to McDonald's. This nigga take my car all the way on Page some month from work. And then the car break down on Page. My starter went out on Page. Nigga stopped answering the phone for like 3 days.
So your car was there for 3 days?
Yeah, so look, I went over to the house. I ended up going to the house. He wasn't there, but his kid was there. So like, yeah, he left the car at the McDonald's on Page, da 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 da. So I end up getting the car fixed, boom, boom, boom. Get my car back. Like 3 weeks later or something, he called me back, like, yeah, I'm finna pull up. I'm like, all right, come on, pull up. Now, when he pulled up, he had gifts, bearing gifts, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? So, I know every time he fuck up, you know what I'm saying?
He gonna look out.
So, I forgive him for what he doing, but I still know in the back of my head.
You're not gonna ever let him borrow the car.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but I wouldn't have forgave you for giving me the goddamn car. You know the starter didn't goddamn work. I mean, who am I supposed to forgive you?
I never gave him a car. He just told him to sit in the car, wait for his mama.
And he just took
the car.
He just supposed to go to McDonald's.
Yeah, you let him go to the store.
Up the street.
Okay, well, motherfucker, your starter don't even work. I don't forgive you for giving me this shitty ass car.
He went to McDonald's and back.
Well, he ain't never go.
You set him up with right. your starter.
Oh, listen. All you have to do is take your ass to McDonald's.
If I would have went
to McDonald's, you went through the drive-thru, came back, and motherfucker wouldn't have started up on who? Me.
We don't know when
the motherfucker
started, not started.
When it did what you did, it wasn't like that.
But it's cool though, yeah. You forgave, but you didn't forget.
But dudes different though.
What's different?
Like with dudes, so like I said, with dudes in general, dudes versus female. Me and my homeboys, we can fight over like the craziest shit in the world. It's like shit fucked up. Like it can be some real fucked up shit. Mm-hmm. If none of my people dad know like that, then I can forgive you for some of the shit. We can fight, do whatever, and it's like with dudes, it's so easy for us to legit forgive or move on past that shit. Y'all are not the same.
Nah,
like even with y'all own friendship, like you can have a homegirl right now. I can legit probably walk outside, pillow talk to a girl, like, yeah, you know, we'll be on bullshit, da 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 da. And they really ain't about shit. He found out we might get into a fight and we gonna be cool. Your homegirl go tell your business is a wrap. You ain't forgetting it. Our friends do it.
We take stuff more like we emotional, so it's deeper than that. It's always deeper than what y'all think it is.
But y'all don't give a fuck.
Yeah, so we curl.
Y'all blow up about everything.
We got a lot of hormones. We
been different. You looked on birthdays. Y'all be blowing it over shit.
Yeah, motherfucker. Cause don't let me come to your birthday and I'm bearing gifts and shit. And my birthday come around and you talking about you don't want to. You got some bullshit, basically. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Some bullshit. You knew my birthday was coming 365 days after yours or whatever the fuck it was. It's the same day every year. Let's not do that. Let's not play games. Why are you on that? You prepare your motherfucking self. I prepare myself for your birthday. You prepare yourself for my birthday. That's just what the fuck it is. Now, unless you're in a hospital car and you hanging out the window, then that's different. But if you ain't doing none of that and ain't nobody died, then show the same thing.
Y'all never think nothing. If that nigga do something for you, I think
someone's
something that
you're
not forgiving.
What is something that I would never forgive? Mm-hmm. Forgive? Let's say somebody do something to my people. So, like, let's say somebody, like, kill my kids, hurt my, like, my mom and shit like that. I never in my life forgive you or forget that ever.
What about with your partner?
It gotta be something that hurt me.
Ooh. Oh, I straight up. Yeah.
You think you should get cheated on and forgive somebody?
See, dudes and Nessie, how y'all different? If y'all get cheated on, y'all take it to the fucking, to the grave.
We choose to cheat on a normal Sunday. Your cheat is not a normal cheat. Like, you plotted your cheat out for
Because y'all done did what y'all did.
Because
I got the move.
You got some sort of attachment to your cheat.
I don't got attachment
to my cheat. I just cheat.
We ain't fucking no randoms. We cheating, we ain't fucking no randoms. It ain't gonna be just no randoms. Exactly. A nigga gonna fuck something straight.
He just met Wednesday at the fucking mall.
But that's still not cool.
Like, even with the cheating shit, it's different. Just out the stream, like, we choose y'all. Like, we choose to be in a relationship. So looking at you, like, no nigga that I know, and I said this before, no dudes that I know are choosing to be where they know and hold. So it's to the point, if I'm choosing to be with you, I'm looking at you like, okay, yeah, she this type of girl, she ain't doing this, she ain't her. So it's to the point, if you go cheat and you go fuck this nigga,
you'll be stunned.
That mean that nigga put some type of work in to get that pussy, like mentally talking, anything. I ain't even talking about that, just to even get the pussy.
Yeah.
So it's like, that's what I'm saying. So if it, like, whole even communicating thing, like, that's low, that's, no, you don't supposed to do that. If a nigga make it past that and get some pussy, yeah, there's no way in hell. Like,
okay, but that's how we feel about y'all. Yeah. Our dick, like, how you just gonna fuck that bitch? How you just gonna
fuck even her? If it's random, why is it that easy to not give a fuck about your person? You see a bitch.
How your dick getting hard going inside something and you don't have no feelings for it?
Y'all still got steps going into the process before you got sex. You still gotta get the number. You gotta text a little bit. Y'all gotta tell y'all lies. And then y'all meet up. And then that's how it happens. Because y'all be telling lies.
Why you feel like all of that?
I ain't with her. I ain't got no gifts.
Yeah.
Why do you feel like all of that have to happen, though?
Because you're going to meet her in the mall, take her in the mall bathroom? No. You're going to meet her in the mall, exchange numbers, y'all going to talk that day.
In the mall bathroom?
If you're doing that, you're doing that.
I ain't going to lie.
With a random?
I ain't get the mall
bathroom. With a random? That's what we on, random. Not like
randoms.
An ex or
juice.
Random in the mall bathroom? Okay. He like, not the mall.
Oh, the parking lot.
Yeah.
It's a difference. Like, I swear it's a difference. And I always use the same example. It's like, I don't want to say shit. It's like, motherfuckers going like the nigga, like, that nigga, he's a known hoe. He fucked.
Yeah, well, you shouldn't be fucking with no known hoe.
I'm talking about jazz. Girls do it. You ain't never fuck with a known hoe.
Fuck no, I don't even like them.
See, and no girl is actually looking at a known hoe and like,
you a damn.
I'm gonna make that one.
I'm
finna be the one that's finna stop him. I'm finna make him my man. No, they probably looking at him like, oh, he knows something.
It depends on a nigga level or nigga status out here in his name. That's what all it
depends
on. Do they be trying to change them niggas? Like,
I don't know if they be trying to be the ones.
Yeah.
They be wanting to be the ones. Like, that's my
man. Especially when he got his, he got a name and he showcasing everything. Yeah, man, they be changing this, that, and the third.
It's a different, like, girls legit go at the known hoes. Niggas, we go at the known
hoes. Y'all be going off the known hoes. Y'all be just want to fuck.
But I think it's the same thing for girls.
The nerd dudes be going off the known hoes trying to make them hit their girl.
Yeah, I don't know.
The nerds
like
making
a trap.
They the ones that look. They the ones going
to Tracy.
trick chasing.
They be trick chasing, boy, they be on it.
Yeah.
I'm just saying. Tell me your people. No, nah, all y'all keep cash. Ever heard she saying y'all nerds?
No.
Not all of them. I can say all of them.
Mm-mm. It's all right. The nerds, revenge of the nerds.
Okay, let me ask y'all this. Oh. Yes. Okay. Real friends out there. If you got a real friend, okay, if your female friend hit you up and was like, can you go grab me some tampons? Would you do it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I'm a kid, though.
I'm sorry, what?
Yeah, but I'm a kid, though.
What that mean?
I asked him twice.
This your friend. What if she can't go to the store? She needs you, and you like right there at the store, and she needs you to go get some tampons. Would you go get it for her?
What does that mean, kid? I'm a kid though.
Tell me what it is.
So you can't go
immature.
What you gonna do? Go to the store? Ha ha! Look what I got. Pads, tampons. What are you gonna do?
You go.
We too grown.
Depending on what type of friends you talking about, though.
I'm a friend.
Like girlfriend, yes. I got a hunger, my dog, Portia.
If me and Chanel caught you and was like, Juice, we at the studio. When you right at the store, just can you go grab a box of tampons? You wouldn't do it?
Fuck no. You gotta tell me.
That's what I'm saying. I might
tampons, though. All this shit is weird.
You want
the double wide?
Okay, so if your homeboy, your best friend, your homeboy, your male friend, call you and be like, bro, I need some hemorrhoid cream, would you go get it for him?
No,
I did it before.
Get that motherfucker from Walmart.
Yeah, I'm just saying, if your homie needed you to go get it, you wouldn't go get it.
He's a child.
I get it. I'm not gonna lie. I would get it from my homeboy. No bullshit. But all my partners know they would never tell me to go get it. I play too much. Like it's to the point, man. I'll be on live. Like, hold on, bro. Come here. I can hear you. Call back, I have the other phone call, like, yeah, what'd you say? But yeah, but you go to Walmart and get the hemorrhoid cream. I'm like, I can't hear you say it again. All right, that's your Walmart intercom. Because
he got to do that.
Look at what? What you saying?
He got to do that because he know when he in there, motherfucker, feel like, damn, he got that hemorrhoid cream.
I don't give a fuck about that. It's going to be obvious. I'm going to be in this motherfucker crown laughing. Nah,
he
going to get a group challenge.
He going to make sure that nobody thinks that it's for him.
Yeah. Nobody's going to see him in the store.
I'll tell you right now, something like that happens just to use brothers as I promise. We come up here. This nigga chair would be wrapped in like some fucking foil and all type. Like, here's the bitch. I still got ice cube, whatever you need, but you good. Got the what's a little good donut.
The tongs, I swear to God. Booty wipes, the little hemorrhoid wipes, tongs, or some shit. I don't know what they call. They got the little, they in a little jar. They like the little booty wipes. They like cool your booty hole.
Girls more the hemorrhoid. Do shit like that. Yeah.
But I'm saying you wouldn't go to the store if Juice called you and really needed you to get him some hemorrhoid cream. You would do it.
I'm gonna get it for him. Do y'all, that matters?
Not how you get it done. If he asks you to do it, will you do it?
That matters to you too?
We ain't asked the second part of the question. We just asked him the first part. Would you go do it?
As long as you do what I tell you to do, I don't really care.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. As long as it get done,
that's what I tell him to do.
That's why you gotta be fucking up in relationships, because y'all just don't follow the
instructions. No, I said I do it.
They don't.
Well, you did say you do it.
I do.
I'm gonna get it done.
If y'all homeboys ask about some hemorrhoid cream and he needs you to get some hemorrhoid cream, go get your homeboy some hemorrhoid cream. If your homegirl call you and say she needs some tampons,
need to do a
go get your homegirl for some tampons, please. Be a true friend.
Are you trying to let us know something?
Mm-mm, y'all talking about booty hole.
You need somebody to go get some hemorrhoid cream. Oh, you're
all right. Look, she changed her mind about the eating ass. I seen this thing on Instagram.
Oh my God. The girl got a fucking pink eye eating somebody's booty hole.
You said you got to get it together and shit, so you'll be all right.
Yeah.
You got to put on
guy. Pink eye ain't never killed nobody.
Oh,
got put some goggles on.
She said it afterwards, though, after she did it.
She said, he was so nice to me. Like, I got up. Yep. He's like, man, you can have whatever you want, room service, whatever you order.
Order anything.
You know, whatever they said, I ain't gonna say who it is, but a nigga from,
what?
Yeah, no. That shit crazy.
What happened? Said it again.
Nothing.
He had hemorrhoids.
I don't know who the nigga
had.
Yeah.
I don't know.
What happened? Let's pivot.
Now, it's only a few St. Louis athletes that we got, you know, guys. We know.
St. Louis.
Oh, you just an athlete?
Be down.
Be down.
Oh.
Damn.
What are you
doing?
I saw you on Instagram. Oh. That's what she was talking about.
Oh.
Oh. Right. Oh, the girl's got to wear goggles or some shit.
Oh.
That's disgusting. Look at her. She got interesting.
No.
You ready to go?
Not with that.
No, it's too late now. Change your mind?
What, the eye picker?
No, about eating ass.
Not that booty, though. Not that booty.
You want to know until after the fact. She didn't know that until she woke up next morning.
I thought you were talking about the person that you was talking about. Would I eat that booty?
My thing, I would never tell you who it is. So you see.
I would want to try. I want to try it.
You male or female?
Why somebody ask me this? Because this girl inboxed me and asked me that. What's the difference?
So wait. So it's a difference.
You know the difference.
So you said
I'm male.
I mean, I don't agree with eating ass.
Period. Male or female. So what you saying?
She's saying female.
You said you're a little girl.
I'm a reptile of yes.
So you're a little girl.
You got to think. I don't think you thought about this. When I heard you say, what if it's hairy?
Pussy's hairy.
Mm-mm.
I mean, I don't eat pussy, but I'm just saying, though, it's no different.
If it was hairy, would you still eat it?
It's going to be clean. You don't lick beards and shit like that, you know what I'm
saying?
It'd be holy. What about the navel hairs? When you be licking and be going down there and the navel hair, like the man, like the, you know, hair. Mm-hmm. Be like, you don't be licking that?
Nope, I just get straight. How do you suck dick without touching the hair? I get straight to it. I don't need to go around the bushes. I'm going to get straight to it.
Oh, so be shaved. It's bald. You don't do bald, man?
No. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying.
So it's no different from you doing nothing.
I'm not licking, going down.
You're not licking.
I'm just going down.
Have you ever licked nipples? Come on, man. I think I need a sex education class.
No, I have.
Hold on, I got a problem.
Okay, so
booty hair is coarse. We know the hair is different from the nipple hair.
So you ain't never licked the navel? You ain't never licked around a dude navel in his nipple?
No, ma'am. I'm getting her. I'm not licking.
No?
Especially when I see the hair.
No. Gotta give
it. Imagine you put one in your mouth and you gotta spit it out.
That's any time. you gotta do it sexy, though. You gotta do it when they ain't looking. You got to improvise. You gotta know how to do shit without.
I did that before you even put your hands on her. I'll play it off real.
Yeah, you gotta. Like, yeah. Oh, God. Wipe with your shirt real quick.
You see that for a long
time. Like,
hold on, babe. Let me get this food out real quick.
Don't say food now. Leave the food part out.
Man, you say food, but get them. Don't say get it out your teeth.
So, no. You wouldn't. No, well, I guess not.
It's nothing. I love Drake, and I wouldn't even...
Drake?
I wouldn't do his either.
He light skin. I don't like light skin.
Say Drake. Drake.
I couldn't do it. But I wouldn't do a girl or a boy or man. But if I had to choose two asses in front of me, it would be a female.
I would try.
It would never be the male.
Unless
he shaved or waxed, right?
See, so you would. You would give it...
I couldn't do it with the hair because I felt like he could have like a doodle ball...
But dingleberries.
Yes, dingleberries. I heard people tell stories about people getting waxed and they had like fur balls and just balls hanging from me.
They wipe it and stuff, but when they get waxed, like, you know, they.
But I don't want to wax nobody.
Dingleberries?
Who will come to you and lift their legs up knowing they have balls hanging? Tissue balls and boo-boo balls hanging from.
But they're gonna be clean when y'all do it. It's that you ain't gonna be eating no ass.
I just feel like all men don't know how to wipe. Mm-hmm.
First from the gym.
We done went to work like 8 hours today and just the shit on lunch. No. You're gonna be clean.
Imagine if they don't tell you though. If it's too many things.
Now you shouldn't be fucking no nigga with no dingleberries.
I agree. Have y'all ever did that? Have you ever seen a piece of tissue or something in a girl ass?
You know me, I ain't even back and look.
Have you seen anything weird?
That's gonna make me leave.
Yeah. I play too much. I ain't gonna lie. You would hate me.
Man, I would leave.
No.
We got some cocaine back here.
Something like this.
It's gonna throw me off.
It's all
here.
Already in there. You hit it from the back and you open it up.
Oh.
And I see
and you see tissue.
It's gonna throw me off.
Let me get that thing out.
Yeah, I can imagine.
Don't throw me off.
I don't like awkward shit. I'll never talk to you again.
I'm gonna wipe some
of Now you just ain't clean then. Shit. You got shit like that going on back there. No. Or like doo-doo streaks on a thong.
Y'all ain't never had
what? No.
I'm just saying, like, the panties be fucked up, or the panties got shit on it.
I see some shit like that.
Do y'all be checking panties?
I see some shit like that. Nah.
But do you check panties? Like, do y'all, when y'all take them off, do y'all smell them and check them?
I'm not smelling them.
I mean, because you don't know. Like, do y'all be, because y'all be doing slick shit now. I know y'all do coochie tests. Y'all can't tell me y'all don't do coochie smell test. Y'all touching it, y'all be doing that little smell test. I'm like, that's nasty. That's super nasty to do that. If I touch it and I do this and I smell, it's on my hand.
So you don't do a coochie smell test?
No.
So you just go in and what if you go in
and smell? I did as a kid, but as an adult, you would smell pussy. Like, it's important.
I mean, you like, sometimes
I ain't that bitch in my wings. You still love American. Not moving.
That motherfucker gonna pop when he pops. And it stink when you put it. Woo!
But y'all don't do the coochie.
But you already been in there.
Come like this is gonna.
No, I didn't. I went to Orlando a couple years ago. The girl I was with. I did her, she took her thong. I want to see what this thing is. It wasn't nothing.
Oh, okay.
I know she kept going to the bathroom. I'm like, man, what the fuck is she doing?
What she kept going to the bathroom for? You don't know?
She went to the bathroom for.
Who?
And she kept going to the bathroom for.
Shut the fuck up, man. I'm fucking hollering.
I'm like, what the fuck is she doing?
I don't remember what you're talking about.
I
wait,
really
that was you in Orlando?
I don't know what the fuck going on. That bathroom had like 12 candles.
Don't lie.
Let me stop playing.
Ah!
Ah!
I'm fucking
light it up!
Man, I came back with number Walmart bags full of candles. What the fuck are you? Hey, Mexican? Jesus, about to, what the fuck you got going on?
About to put some voodoo on that ass. You don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Candle wax on you?
Fuck no.
I ain't never had candle.
You an old freak.
No, I'm just saying. That's too hot.
I swear, look, I promise you, November. Before next month, I got two partners that are going to come on an episode. Shit like that. They're going to come on an episode. One of them want to talk to you about the shit you said about the eating ass shit. Nope. Like, about eating ass. That nigga with piss. Like, I swear you got your phone. I have you calling right now.
No, I'm trying.
He was pissed about the little reel we dropped. He's like, he called him like, bro, what the fuck is she on? Like, what you mean? Like, man, tell her stop fucking faking it. She gonna eat that motherfucker. She need to eat it. Just looking around. They ain't doing it.
But I gotta practice first. I can't just go in and be
like, When we did it, you said you're not doing it. I gotta do it a couple times.
I gotta do, you know, to get good at it.
Get one of those jiggly booties from,
Hollywood.
That's not the same. The reaction is gonna help me get in tune with it.
You're gonna be pink eye.
I'm
gonna have. That's what my nigga should call. He like, man, what the fuck? Because when we talked about it, you was like, yeah, you just want to lick around. You ain't even putting your tongue.
So he want me to go all in. But I gotta become an expert. Like, I gotta. I'm a, what is it? A rookie first, and then you're pro.
I gotta try one booty at a time.
Do it first and then see how I react to it, how he react to it, then I can get into it and be the booty eater.
So if you did that and you saying that he enjoyed it, then how would that make you feel? You'd be okay with that?
I'd be a motherfucking what champ? What?
You know?
Yes.
I'm talking about
what they did on Black Panther. Bazaar, bro. You get to get an amp in that motherfucking nigga just right on me, but see this. This my nigga right. Hey Josh. Look, we on camera, we record, they probably can't hear you or whatever. Look, China right here, right? This one, what'd you tell her to stop faking? What'd you say you want to tell her? This is what I'm saying. She the one who said she just want to lick, like just lick around the ass. Yeah.
But I gotta try first. I haven't tried it first. No. Well, first I gotta give me a candidate first, a victim. I don't have no victim yet. I know. Oh God, say it again. He said there's a lot of niggas out here that like they ass ate. Okay, let me tell y'all this. Out of four men, one out of every four men has they ass ate. I don't care what four
this
friends.
This is our one.
Whatever friends you have.
This is our one.
They not gonna tell you. If you put four of your friends together, four men together, one of them niggas got they ass ate.
This is our one, right?
That's
here.
Statistically out of my mind, I thought about you say it. What? I know it's the truth.
He's
yeah,
that one.
Yeah, I'm saying. Four out of your homies.
Josh, did you hear last time in the episode? Did you hear the way she said she would have to do it? She said you're gonna lay down, she's gonna turn you over on your side.
Yeah, see? Yeah. Light skinned.
He
like that type shit.
That nigga ain't no light ass nigga. She talking about he light skinned. Look at this nigga. I'm gonna have a little, we'll come together. I'm gonna need you to pull one of these episodes and talk to her about this shit. Cause she like spitting on the shit. She like hot wax all that crazy.
I didn't say hot wax. That's it. I ain't had
hot wax.
Nope. You like
skin.
Yes, he is.
No, he ain't.
He like,
that's darker than me.
He look like he be my color.
She talking about he light skin. He just went to Riverview, that's all.
Oh, no. Oh,
look, see. All right.
Shout out to
Riverview.
Yeah,
shout out to Riverview.
Wow. Don't worry about it. I ain't gonna tell you.
She wanna tell you. You said on the show, you said, yeah, my boy, let Gerald, da da da. He used to freestyle in class. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now, hold on, let's one more pivot, right?
Okay.
So, is it important for your significant other, spouse, mm-hmm. or whatever, to meet your child's father if they are mother type shit?
Is it important?
Mm-hmm. Is it like a must?
It depending on how deep we are in a relationship. If my kid is coming to your house, your kid is coming to my house, I just feel that it depends on how deep our relationship is, because you don't need to meet if we just talking and we ain't really deep into it. Y'all don't need to meet.
Mm-hmm.
If you run into him at the store, or we run into her, you know what I'm saying? That's one thing. But not unless we being real, real serious, mm-hmm. eventually, yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, depending on the person, they might say, hey, you know, my kid is going to your man's house or your woman's house. I like to meet them because they're a good dad or a good mom, and they just want to be concerned or meet the person that their kid is staying. I mean, that's one, that's different. If they ask, like, hey, I want to meet so-and-so because I know my kid is going over there with you or spending the night.
Well, who gonna come off like...
Not too many of you.
Yeah, who gonna come off like that, like, I'm big macho, this, then the third, when you first meet somebody, though. So
what you mean,
never know nobody's real attention, so meeting him and he telling me this, then the third, I don't mean...
That's why I said, depending on how long y'all talking and how deep y'all
like,
in.
He's saying, basically, that's like, some of you like an example. So, like, let's say me and her,
mm-hmm.
she got a daughter.
Mm-hmm.
So her baby daddy want to meet me. So we in a relationship. Her baby mm-hmm. daddy want to meet me.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, I don't see a point to it.
Why?
Because why?
Why you don't see the point?
Why should I? The conversation's going to be a 30-second conversation.
I'm
going to
see what
it's going
to hurt just to get over.
Yeah, I can legit see
what
it.
Do you want to know? Like, you want to know?
No, he said he just want to meet you. I just want to introduce myself to you. Your kid is around me. I just want to, out of respect, I just want to say, what's up? I'm so-and-so.
In my thing, I feel like that should be a scheduled thing. Like,
a schedule?
Yeah, like it shouldn't be like, okay, he said he can meet you Friday. He can meet you Friday.
Because then it's weird.
No, not no schedule type shit, but if I'm at your house and he pull up and pick my baby up or some shit like that, yeah, but now he's sitting down dinner.
What
that
person do when I come up? Like, what's up, Lament?
Like, yeah, like, this is juice. This is juice. This is deal.
You cannot.
See, I can't mention
the government name. I don't know pushing it. Like, this juice, this is Bill, this is juice.
I can't
say the name. I need him to say his government
name.
You want to say the government name?
I wasn't going to take my real name. I was going to say my partner name.
Do your baby refer to him as Juice, or does she refer to him as Omar?
Neither.
Don't she say them?
No.
You call my youngest son. She got me a basic his name like Murray's daddy. That's how she say.
I told him his name, but she don't never say it. She just still say
Murray's daddy.
Murray's daddy. Your son. Okay, that's cool. But yeah, I mean, if he pull up outside and he want to meet you, that's cool. But I mean, he must feel as if she really like you and she really into it with you for him to want to say, I want to meet you. For him to be like, I want to meet you, that's like a compliment.
What he said, like he want to basically meet the person that's around his daughter.
Right. I mean, we ain't finna gnaw nigga not at 3 o'clock on Friday. We not meeting up to go, no. If he pull up to the house and I'm nerd, then we can go about it that way.
You know when she first said, I'm like, man, look, tell him he can meet me. Or Jen Station Road,
No,
we're
not pulling up doing no meetings.
Meet me over there on Stillwell.
Yeah,
meet me on
Stillwell. I'll go with you to exchange the kid. We can go exchange the kid, but
no,
we're not doing that.
But meet me on Stillwell, bro. No, we stop playing. Nah, I don't know, like I said, this is the thing. So even before,
you
like.
You got to bump into a motherfucker.
But that's what I said. We had this conversation in the group chat, right? Amongst everybody up. Everybody was like, man.
Type thing. Like,
some people, like, well, I understand it. Like, I don't know, Devin, I don't know anything who said that. Everybody else was like, man, nah, my homeboy Joe, he a nigga you don't need to talk to because he makes shit so worth. He like, bro, you gotta understand, that ain't nothing but a flex. He just he got so much control. Then nigga probably go back to his homies like, yeah, I went and met her little boyfriend. Nigga's a little nigga.
She don't give a fuck what he
calls. That's what I said. I said, man, I don't care about that. I would never know. Like that shit is whatever. I say it's 1,000 niggas that shit every day until they see me.
But I mean, it depends on how he is as a man, though. Only you would know. Like, is he controlling or is he on some bullshit because he want to meet her? Like, did you ask why do you want to meet him?
Let's just say,
let's say
nigga, not
he
over,
just want to put a face
to who's around my daughter, especially it's a girl, it's a daughter, it's a difference.
You see how this person is and. How would you just get
him?
I don't know. What
did he
say?
How can you
see? He probably want to make sure you get fucking no street.
You trying to go
see?
No, you don't look
at your temple. Whatever
that
little
tick my temple.
Whatever it is.
Something
like that.
You don't want to
tick
my
temple. He just wanted to.
No, he didn't say that.
What does that mean?
That means like some little nigga shit.
Like, I want to
check
you
one more.
That is what he said.
No, you don't want to see what I'm on. That's not what you're trying to do. That's not it at all.
Let's reword that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like that's why he wasn't trying to check his
teeth. Yeah, go ahead.
I don't. So my thing, like I told her, I don't think that is about the kid.
Your temperature is like
truth.
Let me pull up and see. Like we get into it. Like okay, I get to it. I pull up. Like let me see what he really on. I'm finna check his temperature.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Let me see if he really is. He wanna check my temperature.
That's checking his temper. Let me pull up on him see if he is really.
If I'm mad or not.
As he says he is. You know what I'm saying?
Test his gangster. But nah. So like I said, I told her, I don't think that it's really about the kid. Truly.
It ain't about the kid. It's about I want to make sure.
Well,
he wants to make sure you love him.
So
what
do
you
want to
do?
So let me ask you this. Okay. Let's reverse it. Let's say my baby mama. Mm-hmm. Let's say one of my baby mamas got a man. Mm-hmm. I need to meet this nigga. So when I found out that she had a man, like she's in a relationship.
Mm-hmm.
Like I know this for a fact, man.
Mm-hmm.
And I called my baby mama on the phone, talking like, man, I just, like, what the fuck? I just want to meet her, and I start crying. Do you think that's about the child at that point?
He crying?
I'm just going to give you an example. I'm crying.
You crying because you want to meet the dude?
Because I'm crying because shit. Truthfully, I'm crying because she's in a relationship.
And now he want to meet him. Meet.
Mm-hmm.
Hey.
So what happens if he meet him and he's not the right person you want to meet?
What does that mean?
Like he
ain't good enough for you.
I don't know.
Let's just say,
I'm into it with somebody. You know?
Let's say the nigga case net me or SPL mugshot.
But he should know your
whole fucking
full name. He got your
name. You know what I'm saying? So you just happen to be dating him. So now when I pull up, that nigga wanted to meet me so bad. And now when he met me, he was the wrong nigga that he wanted to meet.
Oh, like that ain't the nigga you want to meet.
Yeah, like that ain't the one.
That ain't him.
Yeah, what if that happens?
What you mean the nigga you want to meet? Like, she should know that, though. She should know that ain't the nigga you want to meet. That ain't
she don't want to know that we into it. So when...
Oh, the nigga. Into it. Oh, like y'all got some beef. Like,
gave you an example.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah, like... And you know what I'm saying? So what if it's, I'm not the nigga that you want
to
be?
Well, then, I mean, like, I don't...
What,
yeah,
what if that occurs now?
Now, see, now, real shit. I mean, now y'all got beef.
Mm-hmm.
That's why.
I mean, but I don't think it. You would know. You would know what type of nigga you fucking with. I know, yeah, you from this hood, or like, I know you. You know how to. You know what type of niggas they.
No, this the thing. I think it has that. Like, you know, your nigga from the hood and all that shit, right?
Yeah.
But you just sat next to me, like, yeah, you don't get no type of vibe like that for me, right?
Yeah.
We can walk outside this room amongst 1,000 niggas in the city. Ain't nobody gonna play with me. That's because I hang with these niggas.
I mean,
I ain't the tough one.
Which is cool.
Always but, the killers.
And that's understandable. But he not meeting the killers. You know what I'm saying?
You're when you homies. When you meet me, you mean the killers.
No, no, and that's cool. But you're not gonna have like, 20 niggas coming out the house with you because you meet.
You ain't never met my nigga Joe.
But I'm just saying, if he want to meet you on a pull up, yeah, like not a pull up, like he just coming to get I'm the kid. Yeah, but I wouldn't. I mean,
scheduling is a little extreme. That's
how
like
long? No, how long have y'all been talking for him to want to meet any motherfucking body? Because if it ain't been long enough, then it ain't no point in him eating shit.
I ain't even know what your child even around.
It's a lot of questions.
I'm just saying. It's like,
yeah, you want to know who fucking his baby mama? That's what he.
That's
know.
What the
he want to know. Slanging and banging that shit. He want to know. No, he
want
to know. He don't. Niggas don't be wanting to be shit.
How do you know this?
Unless you really in a close relationship.
Are you talking to somebody? Yeah, I'm talking to somebody. That don't mean that they're around my child. You know what I'm saying?
But then what if they get proof that they're around the child? Like, if this person has proof.
Yeah, but how long have y'all been talking? How deep is y'all relationship?
Like, what the fuck is y'all? Are you grilling the child? Like, what is the proof?
People do that.
What's his name? What's his name? Hold it up.
Take a picture,
yeah. We got dresses. Oh, terrible.
It just depends on how y'all got to see
the crayons and shit.
What's
the
proof?
Draw them on a paper. Give them a good bags of crayons. Show me how they look.
Now, when y'all left the house, which way did you go? Did you turn? Did you go by the McDonald's? Or
like,
did you go the other way?
Daddy went this
way. Hey, man, I'm talking about the baby would drop me out with big old ass.
I'm going to give you a couple pictures, and I want you to go to Instagram and go to the follow list. Man. Put your name, start with. Put the R in.
Watch your ass fast.
I'm telling you.
Fast as
If y'all ain't in no deep ass relationship, that I would let that, you know, my baby daddy ain't got shit to do with what me and you got going on. He ain't got to meet you. He don't got to meet you. He's not qualified to meet you. My nigga ain't gonna want to meet you anyway, because I didn't have the episode where
she
my nigga.
Oh, okay. I was talking about, oh, all right.
No, but yeah, my nigga, great. One day, my baby daddy dropped my son off one day. My nigga went out with an AK-47 just off the strength because, shit, nigga, who the fuck is you?
I ain't gonna lie.
Didn't mean nothing. Didn't say shit. He just walked outside with it, stood by the car.
I would have won that situation.
Yeah, that's. I ain't gonna lie. That's,
I'm saying I'm winning that situation.
That's the wrong way to approach.
No, he didn't approach him at all. He just went outside.
That's the wrong way to approach the situation.
Oh, no, he wasn't worried about it.
I pulled up to get my son.
It's about the ups.
I pulled up to drop him off. That shit
never happened. What did they say
about you? I like street niggas because I made a mistake with that first one. That nigga,
too. Listen, I ain't gonna lie. You giving out the wrong energy if you coming out the gate with the AK-47.
Yeah, I like a street nigga. Don't try me.
I like a street nigga.
That's the energy you want to give off.
Not at all.
It's like, up. I feel like, now. I feel like.
Like a lawyer.
He didn't know that time of time.
Now, you know,
like a dentist.
That's like war. Just told me.
He wasn't gonna have no war.
You walked out with that AK-47.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. Ain't no fucking war, bro. It's to the point.
Know that it's up.
Like, yeah, and I know what time to play.
I don't know why you just came. I'm dropping my son.
He ain't gonna say shit. He wasn't gonna
check
I'm
you.
Just saying me. I'm dropping my son off.
If he was a nerd, you wouldn't go say nothing.
I'm me. Yeah. I'm dropping my son off. He walk out with the AK-47, I'm already like, okay, it's up.
I know what you mean.
It's up.
But he not on that type of time. He ain't on that. It's up. He ain't on that type of time.
I'm going to call my nigga Low Boogie.
Shout out to
Low Boogie. Look, nobody had a day and nobody got no shit from TJ.
Yeah. No, he was, he had. You got some, you ain't get from TJ?
I got from TJ.
Okay, because he ain't real TJ. He ain't real TJ. TJ, we gotta get you better, man. We gotta come on now. No, he ain't TJ. Because normally he be sitting stuck in stone. And today he ain't. No, he ain't got that shit, TJ.
TJ.
He barely drunk it.
TJ, this was good.
That shit be gone if he was high.
This was keeping me up.
Look, this is the crazy part, right? I told you what happened. This
past
weekend.
Oh, my God.
What?
Boy, look, this is a hard one. Wait a minute. Because you seen me when I took it the first time, right?
What'd you take?
You know, I don't smoke or drink.
The whole thing.
No, listen. The first time I took like 85% of it. It's a gummy from Cookies.
A gummy bear?
Yeah, like a gummy
kind of drop. Big cube, like, type thing.
The first time I took it was like 85% of it. And I was cool. I was, you know, talking my shit. I was
two
cool.
On one?
Okay. No, I took one. I was straight. She was fucked up.
Yeah, the first time I was fucked up.
This time right here, I'm like talking. I'm like, this ain't shit. I threw the whole thing back. Like, yeah, ain't shit. I'm chilling. This nigga take me out. Get the car. I'm driving back. I'm like, damn, this shit just kicked in. When I tell you no bullshit, I feel like the nigga gonna get out. Like, I'm in the second path.
Man,
like,
look,
I see my body doing everything, but I can't control.
He was so fucked up. First, he opened up a bag of hot fries and ate the $2 bag in like 3 minutes. Bashing it. He was doing this shaking shit. And I thought he was playing because he played too much. He was like, and I was like, and then he later tell me that he literally couldn't keep his hands still. He was feeding me a piece of chicken like this. And I'm like, stop. But he was dead, like, dehydrated.
He came to the army. He was high over the army. That nigga
The crazy part, like I said, love the movie.
That nigga was like,
in the movie, bro. I ain't paying attention to what I'm doing because, like, I'm starving. Movies got chicken tenders. I'm like, what the fuck? Let me get some chicken tenders.
He's bad.
Mad some motherfuckers. Hot as shit. I'm in this motherfucker. Doing all this bullshit.
Who is
I swear, but the whole time, like, I'm telling you, I'm not controlling nothing. I swear to God, I'm legit watching my body do whatever, like, by itself. Like, I'm sitting there.
You was like this?
No bullshit. Like that's how, I swear, that's how I'm feeling. Like, I swear, I feel like I'm watching everything. Whole time, remember, like, I feel like I'm rocking back and forth. I'm like, damn, I'm tripping. I'm rocking. I'm like, why the fuck I'm moving? This is what I'm thinking. And I'm leaning over, laying on her, get back up. And I just sit up and I just start throwing up.
He's throwing up the minute. The movie was on for literally probably 2 minutes. And he literally leaned up and just. And I'm high, but I'm not edible high. So I'm sitting, I'm like, I know you fucking lie. Like, you did not just. And then he really going. And these white people just looking at us like, because we stole their seat.
If we're gonna see where the tickets, I'm
like,
oh,
lost the tickets. So everybody probably thought we was tripping. We did not know. I see they looking at the girl, looking at me. I'm looking at her, and he just y'all move when you throw up.
Fuck no, I said I couldn't move. I'm sitting right there like this. Throw up. I made sure I didn't throw up on myself. I knew that part. I throw up right here. I'm just sitting right. Here. I'll be right back. I'll get some water. I'm sitting
water?
Right
no,
like
this. No, I sit them back and I move the seat back.
This the thing.
Worse.
Man,
no,
look,
listen. It didn't make nothing worse.
Water.
She came back. I'm like, I'm thinking she'll come back with a nice water bottle. This mama came back with like a cap of what, like, what the fuck? Like I said, I can't move. I can't stand. I'm sitting there like, what the fuck is this?
I'm
thinking of water. I'm like, what the fuck is she doing?
Okay. She's like, you ready to go? I asked the lady, can I get some water? She gave me a cup like this big, but I only filled it up like this much. But I was trying to get back to him because he looked like he was about to be over with.
No more edibles, okay?
I don't like shit I don't know how to control.
You taking that shit, you can't control it.
And you heavy.
Because you don't know what it is.
To walk into the car.
Really?
That's why I don't tell you, I feel like I was...
I swear,
I was straight nigga.
Get some of TJ stuff, cause you ain't gonna be.
I don't smoke a
drink. You ain't gonna be what? My nigga TJ got.
You ain't even heard
of that. At least he admitted.
We got the camera. I'm fried.
Nah, I don't smoke or drink. So like I said, it was just like I'm like, man. Last time I had one, I went to the army.
You didn't even know you was high. Fucking
crack. I ain't gonna lie. I don't know what it was. Nah, that shit was seasoned like a motherfucker. I'm not gonna lie. That shit was.
But we went back the next time and it was trash. And I kept telling him that's because you was high. That shit was, but he just kept saying it's so good. I'm like, you high. Like
anybody know me now? I don't like microwave food. I don't do none of that shit.
Nope.
I throw the shit away for microwave.
But the next day or something?
Yo, leftovers. Not the same day. I'll get a pizza right now. I'll eat four slices. You know, the rest of them on the trash. I'm giving away. That day, I'm like, come on, ready to lead the army. I'm like, I'm trying to get up and lean. You just sit right there staring. I'm like, yeah, hold on. Shouldn't I eat a chicken? Like, yeah, I got a burger and some chicken. I'm like, man, fuck it. Like,
steady going.
Yeah, man, I'm like, go to go box anyway, but you was bashing, but we had to go.
Look, that shit was fucking crack that day. I'm like, we're going out. Let me get a little edible with that motherfucker. Look, employee discount. Lil Rod went and got me a great one or something. Cause that
motherfucker
was. Lil Rod probably made them for the chicken. Shout out, nigga. Lil Rod was lost his kid.
Where you working? Armory?
Army, cookies, Cloud.
Oh, he just cooked everything.
No, he cold. He a chef for real. All
right, Lil Rod, we need to get you on here. Make some snacks. Thanksgiving. We need him for Thanksgiving.
He doesn't football. He don't football too. No, I don't eat Thanksgiving food.
He don't football?
Yeah, Lil Rod don't football.
He don't eat Thanksgiving food.
No, I eat Denny's.
We might do an episode or something with Lil Rod whipping up this stuff, you know what I'm saying? All on the show. We might get something.
That's
what we need to do.
Something different. Hey, look. This was a little different episode. I said, hopefully everybody still fuck with it, love it, love the energy. When you put selling, hit that bell. All
right.
Subscribe, like, share, follow,
repost.
That notification.
Follow.
Bing, bing, bing.
I'm most like, definitely share, drop the comment. Instagram names.
Yeah.
Well, y'all know what it is. Love Alone Two Podcast. Fuck with us.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system.
Hey, babe, I'm just calling to check on you, see where you at, what you doing. Call me when you can. Love you, bye.
I'm not finna keep calling your motherfucking phone. Like, call me the fuck back. Drop your location, something. I'm finna beat your